Hello, this is
Hello.
Jirai District of Nomi City in Ishikawa Prefecture. It seems like an ordinary provincial town, nothing special, but actually it's quite interesting. At the time of the samurai rule, the rice warehouses of the Kaga thief were located here. Thus, many people passed through here, and the town developed as a lodging place along the old Hokkoku High Road. At the end of the samurai era, a farmer family living here along the road wanted to reduce the number of mouths to feed, so it sent one of the children to a nearby pottery workshop as an apprentice to work and study. He faced many hardships studying pottery there. He traveled around the country to learn various techniques, and finally he returned to this town. His name was Shouza Kutani. Next, local merchants took the ceramics that he produced in his workshop and presented them to the world at international expos. The works were very well received, and so they started exporting these overseas through Kobe and Yokohama. The product was called Japan Kutani. We wanted to let people know about a town with such a story. That's why when this road in front of the library was renewed, we locals decided to create an organization to liven up this town. We started various activities, and so the Jirai Revitalization Council was established. The short name for this is Terakatsu. I am Ryohei Shokawa, one of the members of Terakatsu. Now, this video project was initiated by the Nomi International Exchange Association. They took interest in our activities, and so that's why today we all gathered to do this video. We've been doing various activities, and one of them is creating a map that conveys the charm of this town. It's a walking course map. I actually have it here. This is it. It shows the course around the town, and it goes in a circle with this library as a starting point. Today, we'll go along this map course with a young lady who's come here only recently, and with a mother who has lived in this town for a long while. The three of us will do a Jirai walk. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you. I came to Jirai no more no less half a century ago.
That's quite a history.
My name is Kuramoto. It's been about 3 years since I moved to Terai. I still know so little about this place, so I'm excited about today. My name is Kazumi Kuramoto. Nice to meet you.
As I said before, this is a library here. You may have noticed this. It's a station name display, like it used to be on the platform. It says Hon Terai, literally the actual Terai. Of course, since it's a library, Hon works well here because it also means book. But it's actually not just wordplay. The station here was indeed called Hon Terai. The railway was built here about 100 years ago, in 1925. Train up to the now Nominagari Station, but it was called Terai Station back then. And from here, it went through Tatsunokuchi to Tsurugi. The train was used to transport kutani ware made here in Terai, and also silk textiles were very popular at that time. The railroad was absolutely needed to carry all that to customers in Japan and other countries. Thus, the locals came up with this road and they worked hard to make it. It ran for about 55 years until 1980. But then the world changed. The age of cars began. Less and less people used this train, and in the end, it was shut down. The road was remade into a nice sakura alley. It's quite long. Here in front of the station was the main street. It was very busy because a lot of commuters got off here. On the right side, after the war, there was a movie theater. Next to it was a market. You know, like a supermarket these days, right? There were a lot of stalls there, so there was a market, and thus it was a convenient place to live. On this main street, they've held the Kutani Ceramics Festival. The shop owners would put up stalls on both sides of the street. It was very crowded and popular. They held the festival that way for about 20 years, but it became more and more difficult to do it in the town. So it was transferred elsewhere, and it is still conducted. It is a very lively event. There is a workshop and a sales shop of kutani ware called Bunkichi, right on the street in front of the library. It is over 100 years old. Today we got a permission to see inside. So let's go and see.
Yes.
There are a lot of wonderful works at Bunkichi. We'd like the owner to tell us a little about the shop. You see, there are so few workshops nowadays that do everything from clay to painting. So Bunkichi shop is a really valuable asset in that meaning. Bun-chan, please.
Yes, we actually do all steps of the process, starting with clay production, then baking several times, and then painting the pieces. Sometimes we paint them under glaze, sometimes over glaze too. And in the end, we complete them in the kiln. So the whole process is done right here. We are a small business, all in all, just 5-6 people. And today one person starts in the afternoon, another is on vacation. So there are only 1, 2, 3, 4 people here now. Upstairs we do the painting, and in the back there we work with clay. Anyhow, please take a look around.
This is beautiful, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
Bunkichi is the only shop around here that does all the stages of ceramics production, starting with clay. Although in the past, there were a lot of shops in this town.
This is the main kiln, about
the main kiln,
1260 or 70 degrees. And these pieces are glazed. So next we need to bake them.
Before baking,
this one is without glaze yet, only biscuit baked. So with this we can do underglaze painting, or we can dye it to get the color. So these are the stages.
This one and next.
Yes, yes. When you put it in the kiln, it becomes glassy and shiny.
For example, this is finished. It's baked.
Oh, finished.
And this one is painted, but before glazing and baking. So when we glaze it, it will become like this.
Now is the stage when the basic outline is drawn already, And on top of it, we paint in Kutani colors.
Oh, amazing.
Oh, amazing.
Right.
Amazing, isn't it? Besides, it's a difficult task to draw everything by hand. Also, the colors change in the kiln, and it doesn't always go according to the calculation. That's a nice plate.
Excellent.
Excellent.
Excellent. This here I've just made.
I see.
This is starch.
Right.
If we add starch, it helps
you
get
this?
The pieces off.
Right.
If we don't, they stick inside.
Now, there are really few houses that keep the spirit of the Showa era. This one remained as it has been, a very nice house. Here, at the entrance, we can see these things called komainu. They are talismans to ward off evil spirits.
Oh, really? These
made of clay, like tiles.
One with an open mouth and the other one with closed mouth, as if saying ah and mm.
I think it's a very rare kind of decorative tiles. I wish they would remain here forever.
You don't usually
yeah.
see this kind.
Their faces are also well done.
Right, right.
Haven't really seen this kind before.
I tire.
Yeah, I tire.
Yes, especially as a tile.
I always pass by here, but never really pay attention.
Right. Everybody just passes by.
Just so.
I hope they would take care of these.
True.
This is a restaurant built in 1927. It used to be a very busy social gathering place in this town. But it closed down about 10 years ago. So it has been abandoned ever since. We at Terakatsu thought we could rent the place, and so we've been doing some activities here for the last 5-6 years. But now, because of COVID, we can't do anything really. Now, a house starts deteriorating rapidly if it's not in use, so we are now very worried about it. It still has all the license plaques from the time it has been a restaurant, the official permit plaques, the signboards, all of those. They still are all there,
right,
as they were. Wish it could be used somehow.
Indeed. Have we ever been inside?
Of course, of
yes,
course.
Inside, of course.
Oh, I see.
It was used for
very yes, meetings.
Meetings,
of course. People also used it for funerals and for weddings.
At our wedding, the food was from here.
Oh, really?
We live right here, so we always ordered the food here.
Right? Everybody says so. That's why a flower arrangement teacher who had a wedding here decided to hold a flower exhibition here.
Mrs. Seika, right?
Yes, Miss Seika. So about 500 people came here in 3 days.
Wow, it's amazing.
I had a hard time because I was in charge of the parking lot.
Oh, I see.
That's when we put the Terakatsu sign here. The street in front here used to be the Hokkoku High Road. It went all the way from Kanazawa to Komatsu. I've mentioned Japan Kutani earlier.
There were 4 shops that sold this town's Kutani ware around the world, standing here side by side, and this Budokan Martial Arts Hall stands in the place of Mr. Kichiji Watano's store, and workshop. A shop of Heibei Watadayin was on the opposite side. Yasutaro Watano was next to it, and the place that is now a public hall was Mr. Jinzo Oda. These four people had shops in Yokohama and sold kutani ware overseas. On the opposite side, there is a house of a family that went to Yokohama about 20 years later than the other families. It's called Shokawa Shoten. Now it is the only machiya-style house that still has its original shape. So you can imagine that other houses like it were all around here. Mr. Watano here was a great person. He was not only selling kutani abroad, but he was also interested in South America, and he also started trading with Russia. Often those who come through Haneda Airport to Japan use the Keihin Line train.
Yes.
That train was also made by Mr. Watano.
Amazing.
I think not many people know about this. Mr. Watano's salesman who worked in the United States and Mr. Watadani's salesman met in the United States and developed a deep friendship with each other. These were both great men, but I'll talk about them later when we go over there. This place is now Budokan. This house is the only one left along the old Hokkoku High Road, as it was the machiya. It's over 100 years old. A machiya has wide protrusions on both sides. They are called sodeudas. They are meant for fire protection.
Our house does not have those.
Also, under the roof, there is a long board called sagari. It provides shade. Also, mushiko, the thin planks on the windows, they act as modern blinds. So we can call a house machiya if there are these three elements. The house stayed as it was with many hardships. It is really troublesome to upkeep old houses.
Indeed.
I'd like to show you inside.
Yes.
At the entrance of a machiya, there is a mise no ma, meaning shop. The customers were received here. Next.
Oh, my mask.
This one is called oe no ma, meaning living room. In the olden days, a hearth was cut out in the floor here, but now it is covered with tatami mats. This corridor is called Toriroka. It goes all the way to the back. And in the back there, there is a kitchen and a washroom. Please come in. There is a small garden past the guest room. This is the usual style of machiya. This family used to trade in kutani ware in the past. And now there are some thin cups and saucers left from that time, like the ones that were shipped to foreign countries. I would like to show you these.
These are teacups, right?
Yes, such thin pieces they are. If you look against the light, you can see how thin they are.
Ah, amazing.
Like this. If you look against the sun, you can see through them too. This is what's called eggshell in English. They use the English word for this, as thin as a shell of an egg. These were the kinds of things that we sold to foreign countries. This is a demitasse. It's very small, but it also looks transparent.
Amazing.
It looks like it's easy to crush. Please feel it.
Wow, is that okay?
As if you're holding your grandchild.
Ah, it's light.
Light, isn't it?
Great.
On the back here, there is an inscription, Kanesho. It is our family's trademark.
Ah, right.
We've been exporting things like these, selling them.
Wow.
These are a little later in time. They are uncolored, white only, pure white. You can see a person's face coming out of it.
Indeed, yes.
This is not a photo inserted inside. If you touch it, you'll understand. The surface is uneven.
Yes.
The thick and thin sections create shadows. Interesting, right?
Yes. How do they make this so thin?
So thin, yeah. Really, how do they do this?
Seems that it will crack when baked.
Right, right. In the past, it was also difficult to ship these to other countries.
Ah, right.
They say that when the railroad wasn't built yet, they would put big boxes like these on shoulder poles, and they would carry them on food.
Wow. Great. Great.
It's a miracle this piece has remained.
Great.
Well, that's about it.
Can I see the back of the plate? Ah, they are so thin.
All of them really well done, so thin.
Really transparent. You can see through them. Great. It looks like something foreigners would like.
Yes, yes. At that time, this kind of Japanese, a la Japanese patterns were made.
How should I say? In the morning, or when you come in the morning, when you enter, there is a place where a shop manager sits.
Right, at the entrance. Right past the entrance. It was called misenoma, or shop room. If it's a craftsman, that's the workplace.
Ah, I see.
If it's a joinery shop or a kutani shop, that's the place where they would work hard. And if you go further to the next room, there is a living room. And in that living room, they would receive most of the clients. But if it's an important client or an important person, they would say, please go to the guest room, and they would be received here.
Oh, that is how it was?
Yes.
I see.
Now, most of these machiya houses are gone. The Toriroka corridors often don't go all the way back. Everybody cuts them short, and they make the room here bigger, joining it with the corridor.
Ah, right. Right. In Kyoto's Nagai houses, they do go all the way back.
Right, right. Right. They have to be like that. Otherwise, it's not a machiya style.
This used to be a very busy shopping street, but now there are very few shops left. Among them, one shop, Marukita, has been in business for over 100 years. It used to be a kimono shop.
Oh.
Now many people still come here. It is very busy. Let's go inside.
Yes.
The owner of the shop is also the chairman of Local Citizens Association. And also he is the head of Terakatsu that I belong to. I became the chairman of Citizens Association in February this year. Until then, I didn't walk around the town so much. When I need to go somewhere, I usually went by car. The place where this shop originally was is the place where the road sign is, close to the shrine. This is where it was founded and operated for 50 years. And then I moved here in about 1972, right?
That's right.
So here also 50 years? Exactly 50 years there and 50 years here. In the past, the street in front of the station where the library is now, the street that goes all the way to Kutani district, there used to be a lot of shops there. But now, there are only a few left, one here, one there.
Yes, it is so now.
I think it changed a lot. This is the oldest tree in this area. They say it's 400 years old. This is a Machillus tree of camphor species. It can grow up to about 20 meters if it's left alone.
Sometimes that happens, yes.
So it's not so high now because they've cut it.
Right, right.
In the past, they say that in a hollow of the trunk up there, there lived a tengu creature. It's a tree standing in a private garden, so I think it's a wonder that they managed to maintain it that good. I admire their efforts. It's wonderful, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
The elderly couple who managed this house have passed away already, so it was vacant for a long time. But then young Kutani artists rented it for their workshop for about 15 years. But they too all became independent and went off each their way. So for about a year now, it is vacant, as you see. There's a small entrance on the right side. If you go all the way to the back, there in the back is the house where the elderly owners used to live. It has been abandoned for a long time too. But then a young lady who makes baked sweets started her shop there. It's a very popular place now.
Kobiri, isn't it?
Kobiri, yes. Back there at the Budokan, I mentioned Mr. Kichiji Watano's salesman who went to the United States to sell goods. And this is the place where he lived. His name was Shinhichi Kuramoto. In the United States, Mr. Kuramoto meant Taichiro Morinaga, who worked for Mr. Watadani, who lived across the street. These two became good friends.
Later, when Morinaga came back from the United States, he was really fascinated by Western sweets, so he quit the ceramics business and started a confectionery production. Later, this became the Morinaga and Company.
Right.
Mr. Morinaga came here to visit Shinhichi's grave many times, even after Shinhichi died. At such times, he gave out caramel to the children in the neighborhood. I still hear such stories from people over 90 years old.